Hey, we are doing episode 9 as our Gloomhaven run through. We are doing the mountain pass, which is on the north side of the map. There you go. And we are running it with me on the crag part, Matt on the spellweaver, Beth on the scoundrel, and special guest star Maddie and her co-partner Rob on the tinker.
Yep.
Okay, we're going to do this. We are fighting some, looks like some earth and wind demons, and we're going to start off with a city event. Man, I'm sweating.
Yeah, it's kind of hot in here.
All right, here we go. So what's going to happen is we're going to read the card, we're going to get an option A and option B, and as a group we're going to decide which one we want to do. It could be good things, it could be bad things, it could be awesome, it could be horrible. So here we go. As the daylight fades, you find yourselves wandering through a half-crowded market street, browsing wares. Hey, over here! You turn in the direction of a voice. You see a filthy vermling gesturing you from a dark alley. Yeah, you grim-looking chaps, I have something you might be interested in. The vermling holds out a piece of metal covered in sludge, found this in the sewer, writing, I shuffled it.
Oh, this is the same exact one?
You found another one. Writing on the, you don't understand, but I know it's valuable. You can have it for 10 gold. Do you pay for the thing? You never know, or refuse to pay and never trust a vermling.
So vermlings are like rat people.
Yeah, they're like rat
people.
And
he found
this
metal thing that's covered in sludge that he wants us to pay it for. We did this last time, and we paid him 10 gold, and it was worthless. So I feel like it's worthless again, is my guess. So I don't want to pay him nothing and lose money.
Everybody's mic's
on. I have no money, so.
Everybody's mic's on?
Yep. Yeah, mine's on.
All right, I want to say we pay him jack.
I don't want to pay him anything.
You want to pay the vermling?
No.
There you go.
Yeah, he ruined us last time.
Option B.
Yeah.
Oh, wow. This is a different one, actually.
Aw, crap. We should have bought this one. We bought the fake one last time.
Wow.
Dang it.
Well, you laugh and gesture the vermling away. You can recognize low-life swindler when you see one. And that piece of garbage was just foul. No effect.
So nothing happens. But it was something cool, wasn't
something
it?
Something else. Not cool, but something else could have happened.
Dang it.
Well, we'll go to get it again eventually. There might be like 2 or 3 of the same ones in there. Stupid vermlings. Trixies.
Find out their names.
Yeah.
That was Jerry. Jerry the
Jerry
vermling.
Jerry the vermling rat man.
Here, annotate that.
Yeah, Jeff was not cool, but Jerry apparently was cool. We just didn't. We judged him based on Jeff's previous.
We judged his look.
Yeah.
Okay.
He looked like a nerd.
So we're going to go from Gloomhaven. We're going to go on our adventure to the mountain pass. We're going to have to do a road event on the way. Hopefully it's not awful.
So what do we find on the road?
You are far off the main road when you see a small band of Inox approaching from the east.
Who are Inox? Are those people with the horns?
Yes.
Okay.
When you see the small band of Inox approaching from the west, you try to divert your path and go around them, but they are moving directly into your path. In a few minutes' time, they overtake you. You've wandered into our territory, travelers, the biggest one says. We don't much like visitors. You stare at her blankly. Such acts can be forgiven, but it will cost you. Try to reason with the Inox. Option A or option B, fight off the Inox. They'll get no payments from you.
I don't really want to fight big old bull people.
Try and reason.
I'm fine with like being like, hey, don't kill us.
What do you think?
What do you think?
I don't want to fight them.
Okay.
They're bigger than we are, for sure.
So we try to fight them.
No, we don't.
Oh, we don't.
Reason.
Fight
we try to reason
with the Inox. Option
trying
A.
To kill us, John.
We don't have either one of those. Right? What am I? Yeah.
Uh-oh.
Otherwise, okay, so the Inox don't seem to be budging on this payment issue, so you are forced to pass along a handful of coins. The big one smiles and lets you continue on your way. Wow.
How much
do we lose? 5 gold.
Each or collectively? Each. So how much money do you have? Do you have enough?
I just lose whatever he has left.
Yeah, was fighting them.
I would just lose down to nothing.
Well, fighting them we would have lost damage. Started a weaker.
Oh, all right.
So fine, take my money.
So basically, it wasn't good to help or meet these guys either way.
No.
Road events are typically bad.
They either were gonna beat us up or we had to pay them. So I guess we paid them.
Took our lunch money.
Okay. So we are now going to start.
It was a good thing.
The scenario.
Yeah.
Tacos.
I know, no tacos for me.
I used to love walking tacos.
Taco Tuesday. You had walking tacos at your school?
Yeah. Well, I mean, it's just Fritos and they scoop meat into the bag. It's not like...
Yeah, but that's really cool. You had Fritos.
Like,
we had off-brand chips, and then I would make my own nachos.
Well, they had Nacho Day, too, and we had Crispito Day.
Yeah, it was crispy. Those were disgusting.
But you had walking tacos.
Okay, here we go.
Yes.
Yep, about right.
Oh, yeah, because you're at St. Luke?
Yeah.
They went to Carroll.
Went to St. Helens. I went to Our Lady of Rest. Here we go. The Mountain Pass. The goal is to kill all the enemies. Okay. There is a certain shaking of heads that happens along with the mention of dragons. As if the person saying it can't believe that the words are coming out of their mouth. Dragons don't exist, they say. But some giant winged beasts have been sighted to the north, so you set off to see if maybe they do. Your goal is the Ice Crag, the tallest mountain in the Copper Necks. To get there, though, you'll need to head through the Northern Pass, a narrow corridor between two massive stone cliffs that is known for frequent avalanches and other dangers. You tread carefully and watch high above for any signs of an ambush. This wariness is what saves you from being crushed by a hail of boulders. You dive for cover as the rocks hit, then you look up to see a group of Inox emerging from a concealed cave on one side of the cliffs.
Inox.
They intended to kill you with the rocks, but your survival has only motivated them to pursue you more conventional murderous options.
Oh.
And this is what we see. These are all boulders impassable. Well, the ones we see. And we see, looks like two archers in the distance, and then right in front of us, we have two earth demons. Oh, three earth demons. I actually missed one.
Oh, great. Why does the Inox hate us so much?
They're kind of like a Native American people. They hate anybody that's kind of not them, because you know, they've been kind of screwed with so much.
That's fair.
Okay. So now, we're all going to pick two cards.
So where are the boulders? I see that one over there.
There's one here and one there.
Oh, okay. So there's one blocking that doorway?
One next to it does not block. There's two ways. Two-way hallway.
Okay, yeah, that's why I can't see from here. Alrighty. So I don't know what I'm going to do here. I need to see how far away. Okay. Oh, jeez. What am I going to... Am I going to attack?
Oh, no.
I don't know what to do.
Alright. So, here's what we do.
How strong are these things?
Pretty strong, but they don't really have any special abilities. They just have some hit points.
Okay.
Archers are also kind of strong.
Okay. Oh no!
We'll try this out. I'm going to try to just go run up there and whack it.
Let's see how this goes.
Yeah, exactly.
Everybody ready?
Yep.
Okay.
Yeah.
The Earth Demon. Really? Oh, I didn't shuffle these.
Way to cheat, John.
Well, it just is what it is.
So we all, like, flip a card, and whoever has the lowest number goes first on their card.
Hopefully the music's too loud, is it? Hey, let us know if the music's too loud, guys. Out there in chat world.
My initiative is going to be funny.
Here, I'll get on it and I'll check it. I'm sure we all sound wonderful.
Okay.
Said slightly lower.
Can you slightly? I mean, only... Yeah, absolutely.
Okay, cool. Thanks, Next Dragon.
So those cards are for each class of characters.
Well, that was like way...
Well, the song's in it. This is it's changing tracks.
Oh, okay.
It's in between two songs.
Whoever's the lowest number goes first class.
I think my mic was kind of picking it up a little bit.
Oh, I see.
What is that?
Let us know if that's better.
Let's get some more darker.
Oh, because we're about to die?
We're actually in a dungeon now, so...
The mountain dungeon.
Thanks, Next Dragon. Appreciate it.
Okay, perfect. Awesome. Thank you.
Okay, so we got an 83 and a 29. I got a 38.
34.
33. Oh, we're on the 30s. Oh, and you're 20.
20 and 20.
anything.
Okay, so Matt, go ahead. Okay, well, getting that frost armor out. So infuse with ice.
You are totally Elsa right now. Yeah, because he's like the chick with the stuff flowing from her hands.
Okay, the second one's within three, right?
Yeah.
Okay, so I can target both of them.
Ooh.
So attack of three.
Three on each of them?
Or three on
well,
one.
Well, that was the first one.
Oh, that's right.
Which one were you attacking, the yellow base one?
Because the next one was a null.
So three on three, huh?
Three on three, okay.
And I get an XP.
Of course you do, Bat.
That's my new card.
Yeah.
20.
I was 33.
34.
Is anyone before?
Archers have 29.
So archers are going to probably shoot.
Move, minus, okay, so they can attack us from there.
They can hit us from that far away?
Oh, no, they don't. They have only a range. Ooh, their range is shorter than the other archers.
Yay!
The movement is two.
But can they hit us after they move? That's
oh, shit, he goes first. One, two, one. No.
They can't hit us? Yay!
Even with a plus to their range is only three. Two, three, yeah. That's funny. I guess they're kind of like natives. So they're like not the best archers.
Oh, okay. So it's my turn?
Yeah, 29, 33,
33?
Yep.
So I'm going to move up next to the yellow-based one that Matt already hit. And he is now poisoned.
Poison.
I poison him with my special mixture. And then I'm going to attack him. I'm going to open wound him with an attack of four, and no one else is adjacent to him, right?
No.
Oh, and he just got a times two.
Oh, so he's
that's,
dead.
So four, so that's eight damage, and then one more because he's poisoned. So that's nine damage.
He's dead.
And I killed him. Yay!
You kill yourself.
I lived.
And he pooped out a coin.
For now.
For now.
All right. So I'm next.
Yeah.
Probably.
34. Yeah, that's 33.
I'm 34. Yep, so you are next.
Alright, Maddie, move us up to behind in the
Are you gonna go get that coin?
Tempting, but no. Actually, yeah, we will get let's see. We gotta go around the trap. Yeah, get the coin. Go straight up to no, you can go straight through Matt. Go under the coin.
It's like you do a hop over her.
So you can go off your guys. Okay, give me a coin.
Yay!
Of course she went for the money.
Duh.
Why not?
You're rich.
Yeah.
I'm going to buy nice stuff and nice shoes. All right.
Where was that?
And then I'm going to do two. I'm going to use my reviving shock and attack two, and then I'm going to also use my goggles with that.
Okay.
All right. So I want you to, Madeline, I want you to draw two cards first to flip it over. So the first one is three for next card.
Oh, so same exact thing.
Which one were you attacking?
The guy on the right.
In the room with us?
Yeah, in the room.
Oh, the archer.
Yeah, that guy.
Okay.
One. You did three damage, you said?
Yeah, three damage.
Okay.
Oh, my.
Aha! Unguarded!
Okay, now I want you to flip over another one. Or he's muddled. Now flip another one. Hold on, not yet. You gotta use the advantage.
Go ahead.
Flip. The plus one. The three muddle or flip over one more card. Just one more card. Or a minus one, so he's three and he's muddled. And that was the other goblin thing.
Yeah, because the goggles let him, instead of, normally you would just flip the card and just get whatever, but the goggles give him advantage where he can flip two cards and pick the best one out of the two.
And we're all done.
So the goggles are pretty sweet, which
I'm
I don't have.
So
I need
I'm
to buy
going
those.
To...
Yeah, I need to buy the goggles.
Just except you have a helmet, though. You can't have goggles in a helmet.
Oh, yeah, that's true. But the helmet's so
cool. I'm going
cool.
to move one.
It's a nice helmet.
Then I want to attack him.
You're attacking that guy?
Attack him for three and pushing him one into that.
Oh, you're going to push him into that boulder?
Thus destroying it and me getting XP and him taking two damage.
Sweet. So you threw him into the boulder. Did you kill him?
Push two. Okay. Kind of a waste. Well, I guess I'm... Whatever. Oh, there you go. He's really dead. So that's attack of three, four, five, six damage.
Six damage into the boulder and you killed him.
And I got one XP for that.
Nice. They're dropping like flies right now.
For now.
Yeah,
that
for
is
now.
True. Until we get to the big room, who knows what's in there.
I should have died here.
Giant pickle.
Oh, an evil pickle.
That'll be bread and butter. It's my favorite.
I tell you.
Yeah.
Okay. I think that's the end of the round, actually. Oh, no. The girl, oh, they don't. Oh, he does. There is one left. He's going to move up. What's his move? Earth Demon is not going to move at all because his move is minus one.
Is he
going to
hit me, though?
He can't hit anything.
So when they're yes. Hard, they show a lot of ability.
So right now, his ability is move one, attack one, and infuse the field with earth power. And unfortunately, his move is only one, so the minus the one movement from his ability card means he only doesn't move at all. And he can't attack anything because he's just a... Can't, nothing's in range. That would be the end
of
the
round. You lowly earth demon, you.
Okay.
Alright, let's see where I'm at.
Here, I'll let you do the next attack. Now, so, keep in mind, did you see the X on it like that? Like, this card, you can attack. That shows you attack three targets, because they're just three hexes.
Who's down
that's
there?
The attack, and that's the range. This also shows we have to actually lose the card, which is okay. It's okay to lose some cards, we don't lose all our cards. So if you want to do that, good. But I want you to pick two out of there. Nobody's really damaged right now, so keep that in mind for heals or whatever. So.
Yeah, they don't need to heal us just yet. Am I two away from the next guy, right? It's the door,
yeah,
and then... Okay.
Is there a door there? I can't see it.
I can't tell.
Hey, John, is there a door into the corner?
No.
It's just
open? Okay.
Okay, that's one.
Well, all right, then.
And then give me another one. So you do one top and one bottom, and then you can also change that. During the course of your attack,
this is our ninth episode. We've been through eight other scenarios. We just finished off in the main storyline. We just killed an important figure. We just fought in the warehouse district with scenario 8 and 9. And we were just clearing out some side missions that we got before it. So in the main storyline, we just did, 11 and 12. The scenario 11 and 12, where you pick a choice, where you make a choice either to help the city or to take over the city. That's not really any spoilers. It's just pretty much those are your two choices.
Yeah.
And we chose to help the city. And after that, we got some extra little side quests that we just started doing today.
Yeah, because we're not far. I mean, me and Rob are level 3.
Yeah,
what
we're level
3.
The prosperity of the city is just now hit level 2. We're all, I think I'm level 3, about to hit level 4. And we only unlocked one envelope. We got opened up envelope B, which opened up the prosperity, and the new prosperity chart.
Yeah.
For donating. And that's it.
Yeah, so we haven't done much.
So we're pretty much 8 scenarios in.
Yeah.
Okay. Oh, I got it.
Do you have the game, or are you going to back the game next, Dragon? Because there's a new Kickstarter coming out. When does that start, John?
It started today.
Oh, today.
No, yesterday. Sorry. Tuesday.
Oh, okay. Gotcha. Oh, yeah. Yeah, we keep everything. Yeah, it's pretty sweet. I like it a lot.
Yes, it's not quite a legacy game. It's just a campaign game that has some legacy aspects, as in... We're changing the game by adding stickers that mark our progress on the board.
Yeah.
But later in the game, we'll be able to actually put stickers to modify our cards that do attack damage by making them even stronger and stuff like that. But it's mostly just a super campaign game. Pretty much like a lot of people are saying, this replaces like Descent and Mansions of Madness for a lot of people in collections. This is a pretty good upgrade from those games.
Yeah, because I finally have money where I have a bunch of items now that I get to keep, and you just keep them for the next scenario, which is nice.
Yeah, it's very similar to Imperial Assault, if you've ever played that.
Yes, the board is very modular, just like Imperial Assault.
Yeah, it's pretty cool. I'm a big fan.
I mean,
I
got lucky. I got on the first Kickstarter, which was $100 including shipping, but even with the new price of it, which is $120 for the new Kickstarter, highly recommend. If you're looking for a dungeon crawler to kind of like round out your collection, this is the game.
Yeah.
I mean, it plays good solo. It plays good with 4. You can even modify it to play to 5 and 6 if you want. Great game. Really well thought out. Really fun.
Mm-hmm.
No dice. All hard.
John hates dice. Wrong.
No, I hate dice. I just hate it when they can make change the game.
Because you could have everything planned and then you roll a 1 and then you lose.
Okay.
Yeah. So yeah, the battle modifiers are nice because it adds that kind of randomness to it, but doesn't destroy you.
Yeah, the cards. That was supposed to
be that one. Ooh, these archers are.
I do like the cards.
Gonna hurt.
Okay, I have a 23.
18.
47.
So.
Yeah. He's got a 7.
Oh, that's first.
He beat you by 11.
He's just a little faster.
Okay.
Yeah, no problem.
So move forward.
Ask away, next dragon.
I'm going to move up onto the coin.
You would take that coin.
Yes, I would.
You would.
And I'm going to attack the elite ranger.
Okay.
I will use the ice element.
Okay.
Woohoo!
In case you need that earth one.
Nah, I just pretend like they're not even there half the time. Well, I guess I could use it.
So for 5.
Oh wow. So 5 damage to is elites. It the archer, the yellow archer?
Yes.
Archer number three.
5.
5? Holy guacamole.
Yeah. 1+2.
That was a nice hit.
And the infusion gave me another 1.
Okay.
You said 5 damage total?
Yep.
Wow. You got 3 left.
Nice. He'd be hurting.
He'd be right. Waiting.
Is that it?
Trying to catch me. Yeah. 18.
Right. We're next. I think we're going to use our ink bomb.
Ooh.
Oh, really?
Bomb.
Nice.
So this is attack 4, range 3. So the first guy, we'll go after that elite first, Maddie. Oh yeah, we infuse it with darkness, that's right.
Ooh.
There darkness you go, Beth.
Spreads everywhere.
Right, so flip over.
I picked the wrong card. I'll have to pick it next muddle. Time.
Flip over another one.
But it's all confused.
Nope. But we missed.
Ah.
Three.
We shuffled the end, okay. Now we're going for the other archer behind him. Maddie, one more flip.
Okay. Oh, ooh. Nice. ×2 damage.
×2, so he takes 8 damage.
I think he's dead.
Wow.
What were his hit points?
6.
So you blew him up. You missed the first one, but the bomb hit the second
guy.
Okay,
now flip one more.
And now you're hitting the demon.
Did they get stuck together?
Oh my gosh, another ×2?
Yeah, it must have got stuck.
Is he dead?
Yeah, 8 damage to
the demon. So the demon is... Yeah, he's dead.
Man, you killed everybody.
I killed correctly.
Yeah. Bomb!
Alright. So we have to. Now, this card, because we used it, we get 3 XP with 1 for each enemy, and then it's lost. And then we're gonna move up 2 to the coin.
You would take that coin?
Yeah, for sure.
We'll save you.
Nice. See, next dragon said good job. Nice job, Maddie. All right, so I'm going to do my duelist advance.
Okay.
And move me up to adjacent to the archer. No, up in front of him. I can't move that far. And then I'm going to attack him for 3, which is a 4. And then I'm also going to try to double attack him with my other dagger with a 6, because I drew a ×2 again. So I think he's dead.
Anytime you see that symbol, you
so he's all dead, and I got 1 XP.
Wait, how much damage did you do?
I did 6. I did 9 total. No, I did 10 total. I think he's dead.
Okay, well, I'm just going to move up and then activate my armor.
Man, and this is mine. Like, I never drew the bless yet, and I shuffled. That is rare that I drew this ×2. Like, we've had 3 ×2s already, and it's only been the first round? Second round?
Second.
Yeah, that's crazy. Because you only have 1 in your deck, and then the 2 extras. That's pretty sweet. Get wrecked! Alright, now we're gonna see what's in that hallway.
He's probably gonna get money.
Yeah.
Free money!
Run for the money!
Wait
a
minute.
Ready.
Oh, I'm not even paying attention, I'm sorry.
So
we will do
this one
and this one. Okay. Okay, I'm ready. Sorry I took so long. I wasn't paying attention.
There's no monsters.
Yeah, I'm just going to try to move. Try to run as fast as I can. Oh, sorry. I was 60. And Matt, you're going to be first with a 36. What are you going to do?
I'm just going to move forward too.
And take that coin?
Yep.
No choice.
Okay.
And then am I next with a 60?
Yep.
All right, so just move me up 5. See if I'm going to open that door if I can. So open that door, and we're going to see what's in that hallway.
Things.
Probably. All of the things.
When you pass the... when you, with the pass blocked by the avalanche, you enter the cave to face your aggressors. Inside, you see a network of passages leading deep into the mountain. Perhaps they would be worth exploring once your foes are dead.
Okay, random.
Yeah, that was kind of random. Just said to read it up to get... we open this. Okay. And... really?
And there's a bunch of stuff in there? Is that what you're telling me, John?
Yes. No.
No.
Inside, there's a little rickshaw that's going to drive us around.
Yeah.
That'd be sweet. Are those more boulders?
No, these are traps.
But a sweet treasure chest, it looks like. Oh. Well, all right. A bunch of traps.
And
oh, since I got the treasure chest last time, you guys can get the treasure chest.
Oh, thanks.
Time.
So nice, so kind of you.
I am so very nice.
Should we give it to the poor guy?
See, the problem is like me and Rob are like have a lot of movement, so we'll run up there and grab stuff before anyone gets a chance.
We are a band of mercenaries.
What are these guys?
These are guards.
Just random guards, dudes with swords. All right.
The elite has a retaliate too.
What's the range of?
Melee?
Yeah, melee.
Okay, sweet. Well, I'm glad I'm shooting him with my bow and I'm not going to.
And then there are some wind demons.
So if you're like next to them and you hit them, they will attack you back.
Wind demons have a ranged attack.
Oh, great. There's something else in there?
Well, how can an arrow hit a wind demon?
Really think they're just gonna have three guys in a room that big for us?
I was just thinking that we would be lucky and it'd be fine.
Please don't die.
Lucky?
I might.
Have you been playing this game? You
feeling lucky tonight?
I was feeling lucky. Yeah.
You have one more movement, I think.
Yeah, move me just to one of the sides of the door so I'm not blocking it.
Guard and Wind Demon are going. Go ahead and go when you're
done. So just move me somewhere. And then I have a ranged attack of 4. Is there any... Is the elite in the middle?
Yeah.
I'm going to hit him with an attack of 3 with my bow and arrow. And it's just a 3 because I have a +0.
What number is he, Rob?
The elite is 3.
How much did you do, Beth?
3.
3.
3 on 3. So that's my
turn. For me to be on camera, I gotta hug you.
Oh, that's fine.
And then now the bad dudes go, and they're probably all going
to
attack
me. Okay, so 15 goes first. They don't move. They just stand there with a shield. And 2 more retaliate.
Oh my goodness. So don't hit them this round.
Yeah.
But is it range?
Walk up and punch them in the face.
Melee.
Just melee.
We can't even get there.
What's that?
We can't even get there.
Oh, to the...
You can't get up there to hit them anyway. You're too far away.
We're all too far away.
Yeah.
These guys are going to move... 3.
Oh gosh, they're gonna hit me though.
Back it up.
The guards or the wind demon?
Are they gonna like run into the traps?
Probably. Are they dumb?
Well, we had this problem last time. They're gonna move.
Do they treat traps like obstacles that they can't move through? Do we know?
No, they don't.
So yeah, they're all gonna run into the traps.
It seems really odd that they would build it that way.
Maybe they did that on purpose.
I think they just stand there.
Yeah. I don't know.
Do they have ranged attack? Or?
They do, yeah. I think they just stay there. Because they can't get any closer to you.
Just move up the one wind demon that's far away. Because he'll probably move up. I can't imagine they would step into the traps. That doesn't make any sense.
Yeah, I don't know. Yeah, that doesn't make any sense.
They see them. They planted them there. They should know they're there.
I don't understand that interaction. Even though I read online that says that's what they do, I don't understand that interaction.
Yeah.
That's their problem.
Yeah.
Okay.
Alright, what are we at?
You.
66. Alright, Maddie, move us up to the door. 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. We're on the door. Okay.
We'll defend you.
You're gonna hide behind me because you're short and tiny.
And that was a really bad range.
Yeah. Luckily, they didn't hit me this time, and they'll probably hit me.
I don't know. I can do a hook gun too. Have these have the guards already attacked?
Yeah, they've all went. So it's just us that's left.
Okay, I'm gonna attack one.
So I hit the middle one.
The strongest one.
Yeah, no, the yellow bases are the stronger ones.
I'm good. Good.
You're not gonna do anything.
I can't.
Oh, okay. Yeah. Oops, sorry. There we go.
Actually, hold on. Maybe I'll. I could hit him if I wanted to.
Try to hit one if you can.
Alright, I'll use my boots and move 2-4.
Aw, you're so nice.
And then I've got my hook gun.
No!
Alright, I'll attack the elite. Oh, hooker. 2-1-2. And then. Attack 2. Maddie, flip a card for me.
Flip an awesome card. There we go.
So they do 3 damage. Really.
So it's got what's the number six is total. It? 3, oh, I believe. Yeah. So it's up to 6. Which I don't know if that's anywhere close to its hit points.
That's pretty
cool. Yeah, it's got 4.
Oh. Okay, so we just
got... Oh, it's the elite? Why the elite? Oh, you cracked it up? You two know it has retaliate 3 right now, right?
Well, but I hit it. It's a ranged attack, though.
Oh, so did you not hook them that close then? Oh, is the hook the attack?
Yeah, and then it pulls too. But it's, oh, still, it's still.
So he gets hit with the hook and then it pulls him forward. Mm-hmm. So it is a ranged attack. So yeah, you're fine. You're good. You're good.
I guess it's to me?
Yep.
Everybody else is gone.
Yep, just you. You're last.
I don't know. Yeah.
Yeah.
I'm okay with that.
Oh, I'm gonna have to put Link into bed in a second.
Either one of you been damaged?
No, not yet. I will next turn. Or that, yeah.
Get away.
Run away!
Back away.
Well, thanks for hanging out with us, Next Dragon. If you haven't already, don't forget to hit that follow button so you can see when we pop on. We do play pretty early on Sundays at 3 p.m. Eastern. You might be able to catch us some more at a reasonable time for you then on Sundays.
Well, anyway, well, good night since it's 2 a.m. in Germany.
Yeah, good night and farewell.
See ya.
See you later. Thanks for stopping by. So, yeah, he's in Germany.
That's pretty cool.
Isn't that cool?
So I'm going to attack the elite, I guess. 4-3 attack with range to attack. Miss. Okay.
Well, I guess I'll do this. I wonder if they still have retaliate.
Oh, yeah, I don't want that.
Yeah, I'm going to do this. And then after this turn, I'm going to go put
they still
bed. Need to alarm anybody. Oh, there we go.
Thanks for the follow, Next.
Thanks, Next Dragon. For being followed. So they like, it's pretty much like liking our page, so they'll get notified when we play.
It's like Twitter, same premise, follows. Twitter? Instagram.
I don't Twitter. Yeah.
Okay.
I'm done. What are you doing, Rob?
Oh, you want it?
Yeah, it's over. Round's ended.
I know. I did my new round.
We all died.
We all died.
The end.
Hey, guys. No more.
Yeah. Man, I feel like I should use that. I'm going to get out of the way. No. At least Sushi Go, yeah, it's a happy game. I always do really bad in it, though. I always try for the sashimi, where you have to have 3 or whatever, and I always end up with too much, where it counts. Is that the one where it counts for nothing if you get too many? I'm trying to remember.
No, that's Edamame.
Oh, the Edamame?
Edamame, whatever.
Edamame.
You one, you get...
Oh, the sashimi, you need three, but I would only get two, so it counted for nothing. That's what it was.
Also, the tofu, yeah. Once you hit, like, the third one, it counts.
Yeah. Yeah. Oh, Sushi Joe. What? I just sit there, I play badly, and then I just want to eat sushi. And tempura is the way to go. Everyone goes for tempuras, though. Yeah.
Okay, ready?
I am ready. Let's do this. We got
the guard. And we have Wind Demon.
73.
Oh, we're all going last.
Okay.
I was trying to not get hit by the elite.
Oh, me too. It's going to hit me now. Thanks, Rob.
You're welcome. Good job, man.
So
there. 69. Okay. Guard is going to hit
me.
It is going to hit you.
As long as you heal me, Rob, I'm okay with this.
It's gonna hit you for guard for 3 damage.
Oh, that's not bad. That's not bad.
The other guards are going to move up 2.
Oh, that like ruined my plan.
Move into there.
I completely ruined my plan.
Go for it.
Beth get hit for 2 more.
No.
Rob get hit for 1.
Yeah.
Well, that changes.
That's me, because that worked perfectly for my plan.
Well, good for you.
Well, now you just need to wipe out these 3 guys and hope for
you. So, I don't know what I'm going to do here. That ruined my plans, dudes.
Oh, God, the Wind Demons are supposed to go first.
Alright, well, I'm just going to attack the middle guy for 2, because I can't do what I was going to do. And I'm going to make him poisoned as well. So
which one's poisoned?
The middle guy.
The elite?
Yeah, that's with a 3 attack, and he's poisoned, so 4. He dead?
Yes.
Yay!
You take 2 damage.
That's fine. As long as he's dead. And then...
Thank you, my dear.
I'm just going to move to... Can I move?
You can grab money.
You can go in between them. If you want to move forward.
Yeah, but I'm just like worried I'm going to be more in the way because then they could both hit me next turn. You can
step ahead of them.
I don't know. Yeah, just move me too. Just because, I got to get up there somehow. So, I just hopefully I'll go first before them. Yeah. Hit one. Well, anyway, I'm going to do a short rest on my turn. All right.
I'm 73.
69.
Yeah, you're going to be next.
What's John 77?
They Wind Demons can't go, so they already went.
So, I'm going to move up 4 next to Rob. And I'm going to attack both of them.
Maddie, pick me a card. I have to discard a card.
Infused with fire.
I'm cool with that. I'm okay with that. Wasn't a bad card.
Just so you know, Rob, you don't have to push or pull the full amount.
Oh, okay. You can choose? Oh, that's nice.
Yeah, I wouldn't have done it.
Alright, and then I will be right back.
Link,
are you ready to go to bed?
Actually, it helped because that made it close enough for you to hit.
Yep, it did.
So, first one I'm going to do 6.
Oh.
Who are you targeting first?
The one closest to me.
Alright, number 1 takes 6.
How much damage to what?
6 to number 1.
So, the guard? He's just a regular dude, right?
Yep.
No.
And I will do 5 to the other one.
Okay. What was the other one's number?
Five.
Hold my x2 and +2.
How much does these have, like, 2-7?
8.
They're pretty...
The elites have 10. Okay, so is it to me now? I'm last to go?
I'm 73.
Oh, you're still before me.
Okay, that's
just attack. Attack number five.
Huh. It does. It goes right through them.
They move through the traps?
Yeah.
So. We just do one damage to number five. These knuckleheads just run on the traps?
Yeah. They all get three damage. I'm going to put them there because they would have moved there last turn.
Well, we did one damage.
Yeah, not very effective.
Number five. We did an amazing hit. Rattle me off on numbers, guys.
One's to the left and five to the right.
Of the wind demons.
Oh, 3, 5, 4.
3, 5, 4.
From left, my left and right.
Then you go ahead and take the traps off the horde. 3, 5.
The traps underneath. Once they step up.
So that there's no other way to go through, that's the way they go through. It's weird that he would design it that way. That's because that was our starting point.
Yeah.
But it says, as the official... what's it called? FAQ, official FAQ.
Interesting.
Apparently. Idiots. Oh, well. Well, even more embarrassing.
Those two are dead?
Yeah. What? They only have 3 hit points.
Okay, now I really question why you would design it that way.
I don't know. Maybe they just kind of didn't think about it for this one, or maybe they assumed we would be within range faster.
You just slap it together.
I don't know. It literally says it right here. There's no other way. Negative hexes are considered obstacles when determining the path unless there is no path except through the negative hex.
Okay.
Basically,
okay.
Monsters will move through as few negative hexes as possible.
Free money!
The next round?
John still needs to go.
Oh, okay. Well, never mind.
You're wrong?
No, there was a path. It says if the enemy... There may be some cases where monsters can't find a focus at all. Well, that's not... Like, if we weren't in range or something, but we were... Ah, whatever. I'm not worried about it.
Oh, he didn't crack.
I'll look more into it. I'll ask questions about it. I think I had it right. I think that they don't act. If they can't get to somebody, they don't act. I think
that makes sense to me, honestly.
But I want to look it up because it's like contradicting itself in the same paragraph, which is awesome. Okay, is it finally to me?
Yep.
Is it finally to me?
Oh, so we did have him walk through the traps.
That's what it said. So whatever.
Okay.
We'll just do it this time, and I'll look it up later. I'm going to. Who's been hit? Beth?
Me.
A little
me,
bit.
Me.
I've been hit before.
Me. I'm down to 4 hit points.
4. And I heal Beth for 4.
Thank you.
And I fuse the battlefield with the power of Earth. It immediately falls down.
Man, is that the thunder or the music? I almost can't even tell.
It's the thunder.
It's the thunder.
The music makes it sound more epic, though, right?
I'm going to take a short rest.
Yeah.
That's so dumb. I'm going to take a short rest. I need to get sleeves for these. I'm going to get pretty beat up.
Do they still have retaliate, the dudes?
Yeah. No, he does not. He's just a normal guard.
No, I mean, mine are better.
Oh, I got it.
So, should I go up there and try to hit the wind demon?
This is a pretty good one, don't
I? I'm kind of debating on doing that.
If I move
forward, so that way I can leave the dudes for you guys.
Nah, I don't give a shit. I don't care.
Hmm.
I need a shuffle. Right. I don't care.
I don't know what to do here.
Ready?
No, I'm sorry. I'm thinking
pick 2.
Stuff.
Everybody ready? We got wind demons and garb.
All right.
Yeah, I did already.
Okay.
I waned them.
All right. Yeah, I'm ready.
Ready? Oh. Garb. Moving his head.
I am an 11.
38.
20.
Anything beating 11?
We're going.
Sweet. So I'm going to move up there.
Go.
Up, right up in front of the wind demon.
How many movement?
3. So yeah, just put me right in front of him. Right back one. Right there. Oh wait, no, not on the coin. Put me not on the coin.
Right.
Yeah, right there. So I'm going to he's poisoned now.
Why don't you move here, Beth? That's 3.
I don't want the coin. I just don't want the coin. Don't ask why.
Well, at least move closer to the door.
Okay, that's fine. Move me there. Yeah, that's fine.
I don't care about the coin. I just want you to get close to the door.
That's my special objective. I don't want coins this game. So he is now poisoned, and then I'm going to attack him for 4. Oh, 3. So it's still a 4 because he's poisoned.
How much?
4 total with the poison.
4.
Poison delete.
2 shields, so he takes 2.
Dang it.
Yeah, he's still dead.
Yay!
That's right, step in the trap.
5. Well, he would have been dead either way.
I was wanting to make sure he was going to die. I was like, I don't want him attacking me. He needs to die. Yeah. Yay! Another coin.
More money!
Money! No. Money!
I mean, those guys wouldn't have been that tough anyway. They didn't have any shield. Oh, they had 2 shields and 3 hit points, so 5 hit points. They're not that tough. Alright. So what was yours, Steph, Beth?
Yep, I'm done. It's after Rob, 11.
66.
It's going to be Matt for 20.
20. So I'm going to attack both of those guys. So I'll do the one closest to me for 2.
What number is he? 1. He's dead.
And the other guy for 4.
He's also dead.
Yay. And then you use fire.
Nice. We're plowing through them.
And I will... I'll move 4 between Beth and the trap.
You're going to be hanging out with me? Hey, girl!
Can't wait.
I think he's going for the treasure chest.
Yeah.
I think he's the bug.
Get that money, Matt.
All right. Okay. There's no more guards. No more wind demons.
Okay. I'm going to do this.
Hold on, it's my turn.
That was a 38.
Oh, yeah, go ahead.
I feel like I'm keep using the same cards over.
I'm just going to move up.
If they work, they work.
Yeah. Like, they kind of keep working, so I'll just keep doing that.
And that's it.
We all want the treasure.
Yeah.
All right. We move 4. So I guess you guys are blocking the way here.
1, 2, 3. Jump over him.
Yeah, I can step into the trap part of the wall.
I wouldn't recommend that.
Yeah, but I ran out of movement. I've only got 1 more, so I can't stand on it.
You can't hang out on our shoulders?
But I liked it there.
Who's lost?
What do you mean?
I can heal 3. Can I heal myself?
Yeah.
Yeah, if it says you can, yeah, go for it.
Well, I only have 1 down. Who else needs any more?
I'm down 3.
Okay, well, you're back to full now.
Yay! Thanks, Matt. Not Matt, Rob. I was looking at Matt, but I meant Rob.
I'll take credit.
Thanks, guys.
Shamelessly.
That chest seems like it's going to be a trap.
Maybe not. Yeah, because some treasure chests, if you open them, you get their traps and you get damage. Yeah. Yeah. Either way. I'm going to leave it alone for now. And it has nothing to do with my personal quest on this adventure.
Okay. We can
see
if that rat was helpful for us.
Yeah.
I like that idea.
Who gets some
good
out of it?
Yeah. Bomb. It's probably a bomb. That would be funny.
A small bomb.
Yeah. No!
What did I kill all that?
Yeah.
A bomb? Dollar store.
You know, I've never actually smelled a stink bomb, but apparently people let them out in my school all the time, but I never was around when it happened.
7.
I'm 60.
78.
So it's gonna be Mr. 7.
Matt.
What you doing?
Looting.
Loot 2.
Are you moving or just looting?
Probably
no, it's my bottom, so.
Oh. Don't quite get the chest, but at least you get some money.
And then how far are you moving?
No, that was my bottom.
Yeah, okay. So that's always down. So
that's all I can do. All
right. My turn. 16. Let's see. Anyone else need down hexes? Just me. All right, I'll heal myself for one.
Go for it.
Woohoo. And then...
getting ready for the next big room.
1, 2, 3, 4. All right, I'll take the chest.
What's in the chest, John?
It's cat. It's a magical flying rainbow bark.
And you're doomed.
Yeah. Well, we had like a scenario where we... Did we save the cat, the tree? Didn't we do that?
No, I think...
The city? No.
We had a choice to, but we
the little boy came up and wasn't finding the cat.
We ignored the cat. That's right.
Oh, it says random item design.
You just draw a random item for free?
I guess. No, it's an item design.
Oh, this could be good.
Not a bomb?
Yeah, you're going to get something sweet.
No, it's just a design for it. It just opens up a new item to buy it.
Oh, so we can just buy a new item. So you get nothing for free, but you have the possibility of buying an item.
Well, it would depend. Cool. If there's two copies of it, it would be he gets the one and then the other one gets unlocked for us.
Oh, so just...
Yeah, just like when you get the skeleton.
Yeah, because I opened the chest and got this cool skeleton ring. Oh, you know what? I haven't summoned him yet. I really haven't needed to. Maybe he'll just be on... Yeah, that's what I'll do.
Still got another room to go.
That's true. He can come hang out with me then.
He can go in the corner and everybody.
Yeah, he just goes... He does really good for me. He goes and just attacks people. I don't even have to do anything. Yeah, he's pretty cool. I named him Skeletor. So Skeletor does well for me. My little skeleton. Yeah, pretty much. It's just like, go, Skeletor!
I feel like
that could
be a sweet Pokemon. Like Cubone or something.
Nice.
So what is it?
The blue one.
Oh, it's blue. Ooh. It's a blue card.
Wait, I would take it. It's at random.
All right. Good. You gonna have Maddie pick the magical card?
You can handle it.
Pick something awesome.
Don't blow it. Pressure's on you. This is your one chance, Fancy. All
right. I mean, she did good for me when I had to discard a card.
Magical dirt.
Pick a card.
Throw it once, then there'll be dirt forever.
Ooh. Inferno Blade.
Is there another? Oh, that's really sweet. Is there another Inferno Blade in there?
Oh, it says, during your melee attack, add +2 attack to a single attack.
So you just...
I think these are all unique. These are all
I think you just get it. That's how I would read it. I think you get it.
Cool, I like it.
So now you have a better melee attack. Like, you can just hit them with your... Fireblade. That's pretty sweet.
That's pretty good.
Yeah, because you don't really have...
Was it fire to infuse?
Yeah, it looks like it does have to be infused to use it. But you don't have to tap it or anything. You just have to infuse fire. Okay. So you could use it multiple times as long as fire is infused, which it is right now.
What's the item number?
I am amazing.
What's
the item number on the back?
79. Perfect. That's really cool. Oh, yep. And then one goes into the pot.
Is that how it works? He gets that and one goes in the pot.
That's what we did with the skeleton ring.
So. Yeah, it says 2 out of 2.
That's awesome. That is a sweet sword. Can I have that sword? Yeah. The flaming sword?
You got your tiny poison dagger.
Yeah, that's true.
You can also sell back gold. So it could be worth 15 gold if you just use it.
If you don't want that. But that's pretty sweet, though.
Oh, I like it. That's
Don't you have a bunch of fire
stuff, too? Yeah, so that actually works really well.
Yeah. So now you have a little bit more melee attack if you need it.
I didn't like how to get the magical blue.
Yeah, you've been drawing good cards so far this game.
Like old base or something.
And the last girl gets surgery.
+1 to planting.
Yes. So was that just your turn? You just healed and moved?
Yes.
So who's after? I'm 60. Am I next?
Yes.
Okay, so I'm gonna move 5. The Moomy, I think that puts me on the door.
On the door.
The door is now open.
Please don't kill yourself.
Kick open the door.
Ah! I'm just the door revealer. Like, I just go and just pop in, like, oh, what's going on in here,
oh,
guys?
Oh, no, I died.
Hey, guys.
And I am summoning Skeletor as well. Skeletor is going to come out.
Oh,
that's Matt's phone. More. Now, those are boulders, right? Or those traps? Okay, those are boulders.
Get out of my way, boulder.
Boulder? I like that boulder.
Can you destroy the boulder?
Yeah.
I can't, but he can. He has the power of Earth to destroy stuff. I'm just a lowly human. I can do nothing. I can just walk around the boulder.
Oh, wow. This room's full of,
full of bad things? Well, I'm really glad that I summoned Skeletor.
We're basically a big metal robot.
So do I, like, do I finish my turn and then Skeletor goes?
No. You summon him.
He goes next turn.
On, before you on your next turn.
Next turn, that's right. Well, just put him in there. He's going to sit right in front of me. He's going to block all of the people that are going to attack me.
Not all of them.
Some of them. I hope. Oh, he is right there.
Oh.
Gonna depend on the hit points that he has and what he gets hit for.
Yeah.
Use your tiny dagger.
Yeah.
I think your invisibility cloak would be pretty good right now.
Yeah, I have it. I wasn't gonna use it just yet, but I think I will now.
Yeah.
Well, that's a lot of elites in there. Look at all them yellow bases. All of them are?
Yep, all four of them.
I guess there's only four, so that's not terrible. And of course I have a ranged attack. But instead, I'm just going to do a regular two attack for the guy. Oh, gosh. Let's see if they have retaliate.
Nope.
No retaliate? All right, so I'm going to hit just the guy for a regular two attack.
So times two?
So, nope. Plus zero, so just two.
He's not going to like that.
Yep. And then put my Skeletor somewhere in... Is there a spot adjacent to me in the room? Put him in there.
It'd be blocking. Like right here.
That's fine. Or, oh wait, no. Put him behind me, I guess.
Your buddy.
Is it? I would
Might
rather
well.
Have him
I
in
mean,
the room.
We can't get there.
Yeah, that's what I was like. I'd rather have him in the room with
Just
me.
Move him out of the way.
He'll move, because he'll...
Alright, so... What number were you?
His life.
I was,
Once he faints,
60.
Okay, well, wind demons go.
So they're all gonna hit me.
Move.
I'm glad I'm up to full health. Thank you, Rob.
We do.
You did 3 damage to that one. Did you
yes.
do damage to the wind demon?
No, just 3 damage to that guy in front of me.
Okay, so that wind demon is going to move to... Range 3. He needs to move here. Yes, no.
Hello? Yeah. Pretty soon. It won't be much longer. Probably be home by 9:30.
Probably less than that.
Well, they're going to... This one's going to attack the skeleton.
Because
okay.
we probably have like 15 minutes left and we'll be done.
The skeleton takes 5 damage.
Oh, he's dead.
Okay.
At least,
he's
you know, at least he didn't... I didn't get
right.
hit. He got
okay.
hit. I'll summon him next
bad,
time.
Right.
Because he can, I can just keep summoning him, so he's not dead.
He can?
Yeah. Well, I mean, next scenario.
Okay,
oh, yeah.
Not this. He's okay. dead for this round. But he'll come back later.
The other one attacks you for 3.
That was totally worth it. You saved me from 5 damage. Your sacrifice is appreciative.
This one that attacked you is going to pull you 1.
Oh.
Great.
Okay.
And we're all hanging back here.
You'll never guess what I'm going to do my next turn.
And infuse with fire.
Fire?
Or, sorry, what?
Wind.
I'm going to go.
You guys are way back there, but it's cool. I'm going to turn invisible next round. It'll be fine.
You're going to hop around. Give him my D's.
Pretty much. Yeah.
Are we doing the next round now? Or...
Not yet. I think it's all I went first. I think it's all... Oh, yeah, John's last. Yeah, then it's the new round.
1, 2, 3. Hit target 3. You attacked the Earth Demon already. You only did 2 damage to the Earth. thought you did more damage. Did you poison him or nothing?
No, I already used my poison dagger, and there was no poison on there.
All right, well, I'm going to attack him, heal you for 2.
Oh, thank you.
Attack him for 3. For 1. Now attack him for 2, so 1. 1 damage. Hey, what's up, Master of the Work?
Master Zork.
Okay. Now everybody's gone. Earth Demon's gonna go and attack them.
No!
Or he is elite. He hits you for 5 damage.
I'll take it.
Really?
Well, no, I'll discard a card. Now is it
lost?
It's lost, yeah.
You lose a card.
That's fine. I'd rather do that because I'm going to do a short rest anyway. And some of these cards aren't really any good to me.
Okay.
Okay.
New round.
And I'm going to short rest.
I'm doing.
And that, well, I'm definitely going invisible, but I want. Grab, pull me a card that I lose since I'm resting. Oh, crap. I don't want that card. Yeah, I want that card. Pull me another card. Pull me another card. What's that? Perfect. I just lose 1 hit. Alright. Perfect. So I know I'm doing that for sure. And
yeah, it's really fun. So right now we're all picking for our actions, we're all picking 2 cards. And then we're gonna flip over the lead card, which shows our initiative, which is the number in the middle of the card. And once we all picked our 2 cards, we'll all flip over our lead card and we'll flip over the monsters, and whoever has the lowest number goes first. Whoever has the lowest number is the fastest person. You pick a top action and a bottom action. And that's the turn. There's no dice. There's no nothing.
Yep.
Okay, what are we waiting on?
Who's are the wind demons stronger than the earth demons?
They're all equal.
They're all the same.
Well, this, yeah, whatever. They're all the same. All
right. What card do I not care about?
Oh, this one was supposed to move up. Oh, it can't. It has movement minus. Never mind. Oh, it also infused. So it's here. All right.
I'm
ready. Ready. Alright, so we flip over your lead card.
29.
12.
20. We leave, flip over our wind demon, which is supposed to be shuffled.
Get up there and stab him in the face.
You gotta get that kind of slow.
Same exact. Awesome. Okay.
Anything beat a 12?
21.
Alright, so I'm infusing the room with darkness, and I'm going to turn invisible.
Okay.
And then I'm just going to move 2. Just move me so I'm blocking the way. Because I'm, yeah, so I'm an obstacle for them. Yeah. And that is my turn. That's all I'm doing. But I'm invisible. You can't see me.
They're just moving the doorway. Okay. Next is Wind Demons 21.
20.
20?
So moving me up 4. And I'm going to recover all of my lost cards.
Okay. Next is Wind Demons. Wind Demon, their range is 3. This, they moves here. Stops.
Aha!
This one can't move. Well, I guess he can move. His movement. Got the move to here. Ooh, I don't know if he wants to do that, but he has no choice. Whew.
Take that.
Okay, so the wind demon moves up and attacks me. Okay, and it attacks me for +1, just damage, 3. So I have to, where's my, I have to, fuck it, I take 1 damage.
So he's hitting you?
Yep.
I didn't think he could move that. I didn't think about it.
He's going to pull me up here.
Sorry.
He can move through people. He moved through his own people.
Sorry, I wasn't thinking about that. Well, at least I blocked a couple of them.
Okay.
Yeah. Alrighty.
Yep.
And then it's
29. Is me, I think.
Do any of those dudes go, or they went? They went. I think Rob's so last then.
No, hold on. Stop. I'm 29. I said twice.
Oh, I thought you went. No. Sorry. Gotcha.
I'm going to go ahead and go if that's allowed.
Sorry.
I think I'm going to just hit this guy.
Whack him.
For four. Whack him for four.
So you hit the wind demon for four?
Yeah, which is number four. It takes...
Oh, they... Do they all have shields, or just the wind demons have shields?
Just the wind demons.
Okay.
Number
two. I'm cool with that, then. Okay.
He only has 5 hit points, so...
Alright.
Alright, next, 42. Anything higher?
Nope.
Earth demons can't do anything.
Well, the ones, is the one gonna try to move up or no? Just stay with that.
Like,
yeah.
I can just move here, I guess.
Yeah. All right.
Whoa, move space.
Yeah, I know. So intimidating.
Oh, I guess you can move 2 space.
Not if you go.
Yeah, I think
you're last, Rob.
You're last, Rob.
All right. 6, 6, move 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. That's everybody.
Perfect.
And we're going to hit these two guys with 2 reviving shocks.
Ooh.
Shocking.
And the first guy, flip it. He's muddled.
Ooh.
The wind guy.
He and knows nothing.
Flip it again.
Can't just go up and down.
Oh, but he'll only take 0. Muddled. And the next guy.
That's all right.
Flip.
Hit the next guy.
Take 2 damage.
Is it 4 damage total?
First guy takes none, he's muddled, and the second guy just...
The earth demon gets 2.
Are you dealing? Oh, the earth demon?
Yeah.
Yeah, he gets 2, so she's at 5 right now. Because I hit him for 3.
That was pretty sad.
That's alright, you get up there with your sword and you'll do something cool. We'll be fine.
Okay.
Alright. I'm ready when you guys are. I'm visible. Can you see me?
I'm sure Arresta.
Oh, yeah. He made this table, actually. So,
I don't... Yeah, I just made it. I made it myself. The 6x4 table. Homemade.
Yep. So it's really nice.
How many hit points does the wind guy have?
We didn't want to pay for that geek sheet table, so we just made one ourselves. Well, he made it. I just watched him make it in our garage. So yeah, and then we have different like coverings. So we have like a soft microfiber one, like the geek sheet that we'll put down for when we're playing different games. But yeah. We think the hard black just looks better.
The number 4. Is down to 3 hit points. The one in front of that is down to not even half. 7?
Yeah, and it's got a shield. The wind demons are beefy.
Oh, he's got 7?
Yeah.
And he's got
2, 3. Yeah. Okay. Yep. I'm gonna hopefully kill a wind demon on my turn. Hopefully, but we'll see. Oh yeah, where'd you get the layout for it?
I just searched on Reddit. I just went on the board game Reddit and searched for gaming table builds, and it was like the 4th one or 5th one down. It was a whole post. It's just a simple 6x4 frame with it was actually pretty simple, to be honest.
How much did we spend? Like $300.
I spent about more than I should have. I bought red oak instead of just regular pine or oak, so it was like $350 to $400.
That's still cheaper than a geek sheet table.
I made it a little bigger than I kind of wanted, and the cup holders I added later. Yeah. I still haven't made the top yet. I have the wood for it, but I haven't made the top cover yet.
Yeah, to make it like a dining room table-esque at some point, but yeah. Yeah, but we don't really, we eat on the couch
for dinner. Yeah, we had on the couch with the other little table in the other room.
So. Yeah, so we don't need it that much. We don't got a big family yet.
Thanks, though.
Yeah. Ready?
Yep.
60.
53.
26. Looks like it. Unless, let's see what the wind demons and the earth demons pull.
Nothing.
That would be funny. Like, no, just you can't do anything this turn.
Sometimes they do that.
That is true. And it's really nice when that happens. Oh, and did the knight go down? The knight should went down one, I believe. Yeah.
Okay, the earth demon's going to heal himself.
Oh, great.
Wind demon's got a shield, and he's going to change something into wind.
Does the earth demon have any heal for?
He's going to heal for 3 on turn 40.
Okay, so I'm
you're first. Get up there, Rob. Kill them.
All right.
Take your sword.
So first up is my net shooter.
I'm going to target
the first two guys.
The wind
I'm also going to use my goggles.
Two?
Oh, so you're hitting the wind demon.
Oh, the wind demon goes first. Two. It's a 2, sorry.
Oh, I thought it was a 20.
So this gets jacked.
No, I needed that for my turn. Damn it.
Does he attack or does
he is going to move minus 1 attack. He's going to attack. Are you visible yet, Beth?
No, I'm still invisible.
So it's just the ones that's going to attack me?
Man,
he stole my darkness.
I'm no longer Batman.
He's gonna, he can't.
Why not?
Yeah.
Just because it can't, because this a wall is right here.
That's the door.
No, there's a wall up to the door. There's a wall.
Oh yeah. Okay. Yeah.
Can he hit Rob?
No. Why? The line can't go near a wall or touch a wall.
Well, why did he move back? I guess I missed.
Because he's arranged.
Oh, I see. Okay.
All right.
So he does nothing.
My turn then.
Yes.
Yeah.
Can I go? All right. Well, I'm gonna use my net shooter.
And you're gonna kill them.
Take advantage. I can hit both of them. A range 3. All right, Maddie.
Sorry, chat.
Rob, you and that mic.
We'll attack the Earth guy first. Maddie, flip 2, 1 at a time. So he takes 3 or next turn. Or 4, so the Earth guy takes 4. Okay. And he's immobilized.
Nice. He can't move.
All right. Sit there, Rob. And then the next guy.
What's up, Terrorblaze?
Do it again. Vanish again. Yep. What? Is it 3 or flip again?
Or oh, nice.
Five.
Kill him.
The wind demon's dead?
Oh, sorry. I thought you were attacking.
No, the wind demon.
Wind demon.
3. Yeah, he's dead.
5. So, yeah. Sweet. Nice, Rob.
Okay.
You killed something.
How many hit points did the other guy have left?
The earth demon? Not 4. Many. 4.
All right.
Hey, what's up, Terrorblaze?
I believe in you and your strength. Should have used one of these. Bad now.
Yeah, I can't do it.
Oh well. You'll get them next time.
I can cheat like that.
That's alright. All right, you'll get him next time. You're just gonna move?
Anyone object to me blocking the door? Well, that's for anybody.
Not really.
No, because we can move.
You're gonna be on the door?
Yeah.
That's fine.
Yeah, moving on to the block.
I can move 3, yeah.
Yeah.
On the door and block it.
Yeah, this game's pretty sweet.
Pretty fun. Pretty cool combat system.
The fact that there's cards instead of dice is a lot more strategy. Because
you're using the top and bottom action. Your initiative is in the middle, can kind of see it. A red shot.
Yeah.
Is this the next round?
No, I'm still.
No, you're the first one.
Jump the gun. Okay.
I think.
So your initiative is in the middle. You pick one top action and one bottom action to do in any order. That's how the action combat works. It's pretty cool. Pretty innovative.
Yeah, we like this a lot. We're on our eighth session.
Yep.
So does the Earth Demons go now with a 40?
40, yes.
Because I think I'm next with
I go with the 26.
26.
Oh, I was looking at 69. Yeah, go ahead, Matt. Kill some stuff.
Move me up 4. Just inside the door.
On the coin?
Yeah.
Okay, that's going to pretty much not make me do anything.
Well, you can...
Is there a range attack?
Yeah, I can hit all 3.
Okay. Oh, okay.
He may kill the guy that's in
your
Yeah, he might.
That's true. Yeah.
5.
You wouldn't like it.
Yeah, you might. Yeah, if you kill him, that'll work.
He's almost dead, too.
Yeah, he only needs 4.
4.
Okay, so unfortunately, I'm going to take a disadvantage on him, but.
Oh, because it's ranged.
Yeah.
You can do it, Rob. Okay.
So I'm going to do 3.
Matt, God, sorry.
He's still alive.
Why do I keep calling you guys each other's names today? I'm sorry.
Did 3 damage?
Well, yes. This is Matt, and that's
nope. Rob.
Not dead.
He's gonna heal it this next turn anyway.
Oh, that sucks.
What's he healing for?
3 damage.
So your attack was nothing.
Nothing.
I got attacked. So attack the other guy for 3.
Yeah, the Kickstarter just started yesterday. If you're in the mood for a dungeon crawler of any sort, this is, I think, the best dungeon crawler game that there's.
Oh,
out
by
there.
Far.
6/3.
Cool campaign system. How much is this?
6/3.
It's just Imperial Assault was... Oh, he's going to heal anyway.
Well,
Imperial Assault, I thought,
Wind
was boring
Demon takes 4.
Compared to this.
So it takes 2. What number is he? Oh, he's the only one left.
Oh, really? Okay. Alright.
Alright, now they go, they heal. They get a mass full turn. GG. GG.
Alright.
And then...
I'm
What number are you? What,
I'm 60.
I'm 50.
Do they move at all?
53.
I think it's the Earth Demon's turn
they
right now.
They do move.
Either way, I'm going to move up and try
no,
to
No, they don't. I'm sorry. They have no move.
Okay. I'm going to try to kill the Earth Demon because the Wind Demon only has
okay,
one
so
hit
on
point.
Okay, so on my turn, I'm going to...
Right? The Wind Demon only has one hit point. Is that what you said?
Yeah. Can't do anything. I will move and attack.
Yeah, I think he's actually going
to
buy
and I'm going to
some
take,
parts of the Kickstarter.
I want to get my miner stand on up.
Because it has like an updated rule book that I think we're going to buy.
And the better dials that I made. Well, like Imperial Assault has been pretty much my favorite up to now. I'm just not a huge fan of the dice combat. I played Descent, just wasn't a huge fan of the... I mean, the dice combat kind of turned me off.
Yeah.
But Imperial Assault with the theme was really cool. Yeah.
But my favorite games, I really like...
Dungeon Crawler?
No, non-Dungeon Crawler.
Oh, non-Dungeon Crawler.
I like Clank a lot.
Kind of a Dungeon Crawler.
I guess it is. That's true. It's a deck builder, though. What else do I like? I like some...
I mean, I guess my favorite's Worker Placement. Between Viticulture, Caverna, and like...
I like Caverna. I like Scythe.
Scythe.
I like Above and Below. I like all those games. You obviously like Legendary. And you really like Legendary.
I think my
and,
two favorite mechanics is worker placement and probably deck building.
Lords of Waterdeep.
Oh, building decks is so much fun.
Yeah. Deck building games are pretty fun.
Yeah, like Pokemon.
Kind of, yeah. That's a deck building game.
Am I next with a 60?
Yeah, I think you're it, aren't you?
Am I next?
Sure, there you are. That's the only one left.
So I'm going to move up to the Earth Demon.
This one or this one?
That one. Yeah. Because he doesn't have any damage.
What's some of your favorite games, Master's Orc?
So, I'm invisible, so I'm going to attack him, and there's no knight, so I don't get a plus, and no one's adjacent to him, so this whole card sucks now because there is no knight. So, I'm going to attack him for 3, times 2, times 2. I got 2 times 2s.
Which one are you attacking?
The Earth Demon. So, 3 times 2 is 6, 12. He dead?
He has 1 hit point.
Gah! Dang it. I got 2 times 2s. That's pretty sweet.
Rum and Bones, you got all the Kickstarter items?
Oh, that's awesome. Rum and Bones looks really cool.
Only thing that turned me off about Rum and Bones was that it's just pretty much a 2-player game. That's the only thing that turned me off the game.
Man, I thought I'd kill
it. And I'm not a huge pirate theme kind of guy. I like pirate themed games, but they're not like, I don't know.
I think I'm
not
last.
My favorite.
All right, initiative.
Oh, look, there you go, Rob. Roll for Galaxy fan. We like that here too. It's actually on our 10x10 challenge. We gotta get some more plays of it in.
And I'm using my potion, and I'm grabbing
some
cards.
That's the kind of dice game I like. Everybody always craps on me that I hate dice games, but I really like Roll for the Galaxy, and it is a dice game.
Oh, it's up to 6. Okay. It's up to 6. Oh, Rum and Bones is up to 6? I think you're thinking of the wrong game, then.
It's the one with the 2 ships, and you're going back and forth with minis. Isn't it like team play, where you're each side controls one side?
Oh, you got Mechs and Minions. I want to play that game. We don't have it, though.
Sorry.
I think. I'm going to kill that Earth Demon. He's going to die, and he's going to regret ever crossing.
I'm going to do my same turn again, but hopefully I don't. Hopefully I can do it.
I will try to get out of your way.
Well, it's not possible. I mean, there's not really much room. It is what it is. It's not that big of a deal. Yeah, I think it was a 1v1, 2v2, or 3v3. It just, I don't know. Those are fun games. Just with our game group, probably wouldn't really get into it that much.
Well,
Fury of Dracula is a big hit with our game group. Unfortunately, Spectre Ops, I don't think our game group was like that. The hidden movement and getting I don't know. We haven't played a real good hidden. I mean, same thing as Fury of Dracula, but with a sci-fi theme.
Yeah, that's true. I got 16.
Oh, shit, wrong. Minus.
Oh, 16, 17, 20. Oops. What are you?
53.
And what are those dudes?
Wind Demon.
Yeah. Let me kill that guy.
I'm not going to shuffle you on our like here.
The one hit point guy?
93 and 43.
All right. All right, so I'm first with a 16.
I would like to try Spectre Ops. I don't know if I'll ever play
it. I'll hit the Wind Demon for a 3 attack. The problem is he's got a shield, so...
2 shields.
He's got 2 shields? Well, he'll be poisoned anyway. So he's poisoned. 3 attacks. So just 1, and he's poisoned. If you don't kill him this turn, Rob...
So you're killing the... You attack the Wind Demon?
Yeah.
How much damage? Total. Just give me the total damage.
3, and he's poisoned.
So 1.
Oh, so 4, and he's poisoned. Sorry. 2 damage. That's alright.
My biggest games that I'm looking forward to this year, one that I'm hopefully getting here in a couple weeks, is Heart of Crown, which is a deck-building game from Japanime Games that I kickstarted last year. Another game I'm looking forward to is the next Jamie Stegmaier game called Charter House. It's a legacy worker placement game. Looking forward to that.
Question.
Yeah.
What, 3 damage to land on a trap?
Yeah. We don't have any traps.
Oh, he's going to have to land on that
boulder.
One.
These are all boulders. We can't land on those.
Unless you can move them.
Also, I'm looking forward to Codenames Disney and Codenames Marvel. That's coming out this year.
There's a Codenames Disney?
Mm-hmm. And Tom really liked it. They showed it at Gamma. He couldn't take pictures of it. Tom Vassell and the entire crew, they couldn't take pictures of it. But
you guys both feel for one.
Oh, thank you.
But he said it was really cool, was really awesome, really liked it.
Maddie, have you played Codenames?
All right, I'm infusing with fire.
You would like
it. Infused.
Yep.
Now you're going to have to get the Disney
flamethrower, but then I'm also... Using my
I would like the Marvel one better.
Oh, Marvel's pretty sweet too.
That's not even a tap.
Oh yeah, Spice Road. I forgot about Spice Road.
So I'm doing 5 damage.
Oh nice.
Are you
using the flame flower?
Yeah.
So which 2 are you killing? This guy?
I'm going after this guy first.
Oh, he's dead.
6. Okay, that's good. That was important.
So you overkilled it enough?
I needed to.
Okay.
That's why you wanted to kill him.
He's asked twice how much he's gone over.
Yeah.
That was like 9 over.
And then one more flip.
Colosseum?
Minus 1, so he takes 4 for the other guy.
I think the reprint's not as good as the original.
And move the flame. You use the flame for the sword. But the Wind Demon got 4, so I think he got 2. Oh, he's dead?
Yeah.
Nice! High five!
Double kill!
Okay. Man, you've been double killing people like crazy tonight. Yeah, Maddie's nice. Your good luck charm, I think.
Okay. Rising Sun. I'm not a big fan. It wasn't 2 players, so I couldn't. Every game I buy, it has to be at least a 2-player game.
Just because me and my last guy.
If I'm spending that kind of money on a game, me and my wife need to be able to play it together.
No, yeah, I'm sorry.
Hold on, question. So yeah. I used fire in my attack, but I also infused, but it was already infused.
It was already infused.
It can't double one.
No.
Like it wouldn't give Matt.
Nope, so doesn't stack. Doesn't stack.
I stacked his fire.
Yeah.
Well, unless, which one did you do first?
Is it a melee or a ranged attack?
That's a melee.
Okay.
So did you attack and then use that? Or no, you use that with your attack.
Right,
okay, so never mind, yeah.
I'd say since it's already there, it's fine.
Kind of finagle it.
I don't know. But I really need to see some more information on Rising Sun. I might get it after it comes to retail, but from what I've seen in the couple, like, two videos, I just didn't like the forced team aspect of it, where you have to team up to play the game, which is fine, but it just felt like manufactured team, like, alliances. It wasn't really, it doesn't feel like an alliance game. It feels like it's a team game. But
how much does this guy have left?
He has, what number is he? One. One has one.
Oh, so we're pretty much done. Kill him!
Would you like to finish him, John?
No, you got it.
Okay.
Blow on him. Go. Go. Real hard.
Move me back one.
You can do it.
Put your back into it. There it is.
And four.
He's dead.
Rip.
End of game. Good job, guys.
Nobody died. Yeah, nobody exhausted.
I was getting close.
All right, let me finish off
the
reading. So, all right.
So what happened?
Let me go ahead and change the view for the... I also need to add Blood Rage to the collection. I really want to play it. Friends have it, and I really kind of want it.
Yeah.
Okay, so here we go. What were the Enox and demons doing together?
Oh.
And so far north? You rifle through their belongings, look for some indication of their motivation. All you find is some crude scratchings referencing a voice, in quotations. You glance toward the cave. There may be some clues further down the tunnels. To the north, Ice Crag Peak looms in the distance. Which is number 25. New encounter. Still, you have something calling you to explore the cave. Number 24.
Okay.
Not audibly, but there is a subtle and powerful urge to continue. You look down at the Enox scribblings. A voice. Yes, somehow this sounds familiar. You can almost hear it yourself. ... Two new locations built. that's funny. Two new locations. We got the Echo Chamber, which is the voice we're hearing, is 24.
Okay.
And then the Ice Crag Ascent, which is 25.
Oh, man. Okay. So we got this one and this one up here opened up. That's cool. So we hear a strange voice. What will we find next time? Oh, you're going to get April 23rd getting Dark Souls. Cool.
I think I just have too much hate for the video game that I just, like, I saw that Kickstarter and I was just like, nope, big pile of nope.
All right, so what was your goals for this session?
Hard to believe, but mine was Dynamo. Kill a monster during scenario by causing at least four more points of damage than is necessary.
Good job. So mine was a double check mark, and I just couldn't loot any money or tokens during the scenario. So I couldn't get any money.
Nice. Time. I've had that one before.
Yeah.
I want to say that you can't get any of the homebrew points either.
That's fine. I don't care.
To complete that.
So, shockingly, mine was hoarder, loot five or more money tokens during the scenario.
Did you get it?
Yeah.
Yep.
Nice.
Mine was, believe
Which
it or not.
Which actually kind of helps because I'm broke right now.
Yeah.
Believe it or not, was pacifist. Kill three or fewer monsters. I only killed one.
Oh, nice. There you go. Good job, guys. So we all got our goals during the scenario.
We did.
That's weird.
That All right, and that always happen.
That was episode 8. Thanks a lot for joining us, and we'll see you next time on Wednesday at 7 p.m. for episode 9. Mm-hmm. Thanks a lot, everybody.
Bye, y'all.